Hello again. It is me. You guys are gonna be really tired of me, but I just have a lot on my mind. Another thing I was thinking of is that how in regards to self-love and also how that is tied into your health and other areas of your life, because all of this stuff is intertwined. I think too often when we think of health, we tend to just think of what you eat and how the body breaks it down, assimilates it, and digests it. But I think it's deeper than that. I think it's what you think. I think it's the environment you grew up in. I think it's what work environment you're in. I think it's what you face on a day-to-day basis. I think it's environmental toxins. I think it's the types of relationships we're in. I think it's how you were reared and how your parents' parents were reared. I think a lot of those things come into play as it relates to health. And one of the things I was thinking of, I guess, because it relates to me in my own personal journey, is how a lot of what we think of ourselves, though we have the capacity to change it, we often don't connect the dots, starts very early on when you're a child. A lot of the things that we think of ourselves are tied to how our family members perceive us. And a lot of times, those perceptions are not intended to be malicious. Sometimes the parents are doing it to because they perceive themselves as protecting you, or maybe they were in a space you were in when you were younger and they don't want you to fail like they failed, even though you're not the same people and the outcome could be totally different. That's not the space they're in. And how that spills over into other areas of your life. I think about the transition I'm going through now and how much of what I've went through has been shaped by how I was treated by peers or family, having low self-esteem, that translating into being in relationships where I didn't realize those people weren't worthy of my time, but I let them be in my space. And then they didn't treat me well. Not that I deserved that, but I was in a subconscious space that I didn't think I was deserving of better. And how even in job situations I've had, I also wasn't treated well because it was tied to that limiting belief I had of myself, which when I thought about it and really took time to process it, goes all the way back to childhood. And I think that's for a lot of reasons, but I just was thinking about that. And I think part of with women, and this is going to be a bitter pill to swallow, if we want to have certain types of positive relationships as it relates to, in my case, I'm heterosexual, so with the opposite sex. If you want to cultivate a positive, loving relationship, it's gonna be imperative that, and I know people get tired of hearing it, and I know it seems like it's cliche, but you have to learn to love yourself. Like, why is it somehow that we think, and I shouldn't even be saying this as a rhetorical question because it's pretty obvious why we've bought into a lot of the fairy tale bullshit. It's like, you have to get used to being by yourself and enjoying your company. You have to get used to, working on refining and improving yourself. You have to get used to enjoying who you are as an individual before someone can come along that can appreciate the full essence of who you are. Because if you don't do that, what the universe is going to do, it's going to keep putting you in situations where you'll be a different age. It'll be different people. The circumstances might be different, but you'll keep running into the same types of situations and relationships over and over and over and over. And it'll kind of be like a variation of the movie Groundhog's Day. And until you own up to that, it's going to keep happening. And typically, what I find happens with women, and even Iyanla Van Zant touched on this with her book Peace from Broken Pieces, a lot of times, and especially as it relates to women of African descent, because there is intergenerational trauma or even things with like sexism or racism, and sometimes even classism, we carry these limiting beliefs and we don't realize how much it affects everything, to the core of everything we do. I think it's time for women to stop playing victim all the time. And to really think about the part we play in relationships, when I see women demonize men and say they're not shit, well, you knew he wasn't shit when you hooked up with him. There was a facet of you that didn't feel like you deserved any better, Or maybe there was a facet of you that wasn't about shit. Let's keep it 100 here. Like, that's just the truth of the matter. Until we realize our value and our worth, we won't allow people to waste our time or be in our space. And that doesn't even have anything to do with necessarily being sexual. It could be platonic. It can be, on an intimate level. It can be like in a work situation, because, sometimes even when you're in a work environment, people are always trying to test the waters to see who they can fuck with even. Or you put yourself in a situation where, you're in a toxic work environment and you don't think you deserve any better, so you don't even look for another job. But yeah, that was another thing I was thinking about. Anywho, later. Peace.